9:36. I'll stand for the pledge of allegiance.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Roll call, please.
Ready?
Here.
Sluse?
Here.
Henderson here. Audi?
Here.
Shoemaker?
Here.
Smith? Delucky?
Here. Okay. Approval of agenda is submitted.
There are no additions or changes to it?
Not yet.
Make a motion to approve it as presented?
A second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Okay, so we've been instructed that when we do the DDA, we have to enter into a DDA meeting and then close that meeting and go into a planning commission meeting. So since it's on the first of our thing on our agenda, we'll open the DDA meeting, and the first order of business is to approve the agenda.
Which is the same one?
This one.
I'll make a motion to approve the agenda.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, so moved. The first thing is schedule of bills. There is a bond payment due by the DDA Downtown Street Bond in the amount of $10,000 principal, $7,728.75 in interest. There is enough surplus funds in the DDA account to cover this payment.
Well, then I'll make a motion to pay the bills as presented.
And this, the bills are due November 1st of 2013 to Bank of New York Mellon. And since we won't have a meeting prior to then, we're approving it for November 1st.
Can you do those numbers again? What was
the sure. $10,000 principal, $7,728.75 in interest.
We're paying interest only?
No, this is both. So it would be a $17,728.75 interest at total payment.
Do 11-1. Right?
Yeah, it's for 11-1, correct. Which due on the 1st.
Actually, because I'm not sending a wire, it's due 5 days prior to the 1st.
Okay.
So I will be sending it out promptly.
Okay. Any discussion? Motion to...
Here, you still want to keep your motion?
Well, yeah, it's presented.
Yeah.
I'll second it.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay, opposed? So moved. All right. The PA system. So there is a PA system that belonged to the DDA. It's currently at the Lions Hall. I brought it to the board this evening. I wanted to donate it to the Lions Hall, but I've been instructed by the attorney that we can't do that. So we're just gonna kind of let that one slide. But that's why it was on there. I wanted to donate it to the Lions, because the Lions are the ones that are in possession of it and use it for the different functions.
Is there any way that we can maintain possession of it, so let them use it when they want to?
Sure.
We need a motion to that effect, or
no?
Okay.
No. the way it is right now is, from what I understand, okay?
Yeah. We have to maintain ownership of it, the village does, but anybody, any group, any organization, community for community event would be able to use it.
That's what I'm trying to...
By request.
Right, they would have to ask, they would have to ask, right.
Okay.
So Lions Club becomes a storage place for it?
Correct. Which they kind of have been for years off and on. Okay, there is no chair report in the DDA, so motion to exit out of the DDA meeting.
So move.
Second? Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Okay, so we're out of the DDA and motion to enter into the planning commission.
So move.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Okay. So approval of meeting minutes of August 5th. So we need, we didn't do this because we didn't have enough people to vote on this, but tonight we do. It's only Mr. Audi, Mr. Sledge, myself, and Mr. Shoemaker can vote on this. The others would have to abstain.
I make a motion to approve them as presented.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Abstain?
Abstain.
So moved. And at present, we don't have a quorum to approve September 4th meeting minutes, so we will table those until we have a quorum. Okay. Site plan on WRAP LLC. So this was presented to us at the last meeting with the need to clarify some documentation and proper application submittal. Okay, so the application, everybody has the application in front of them. So I have three applications and the drawings are different on two of them.
Should not be then.
Okay, this is the... No, I wrote this, but see, this is wrapped. This was submitted. No, they're two different drawings.
Just a little bit.
Yeah.
Should be this one. I gave you the drawing last month and you wanted the whole basement, so now you have it.
True, but again, I got two different drawings of the basement.
I don't know where you're getting two different drawings. I copied them all at the same time.
So one has couch, table, podium, furnace, and the other one is blank.
I don't know where you got that one from, but...
From
me. From you.
Okay. You just wanted the layout of the classroom.
All right, okay, so we'll just leave... This was your original.
That's the drawing she wants.
Okay, all right. Because the other ones are all copied.
So that one, this one.
Okay, so that was it, so this must have been...
From the first one, maybe?
Yeah, because this, the rest of them had north, west, east, and south is all copied. That one is in 10. Okay.
We've made no material changes to the building. Just had my classroom down there.
So if I could ask, what are the squiggly lines here?
Chairs.
Oh, okay. I don't know.
We have to sit them down somewhere, Ben. We're not going to make them stand for an hour.
Okay.
But you got a marker for it.
Like birds.
Yeah.
Actually, that's a good question.
Well, hey, didn't
that was actually my question.
Well, the podium's up front.
I'm sorry, what did you say?
The podium is up front, so it makes sense that those are chairs.
Yeah.
Well, now. It may make sense.
Now.
Now it makes sense. Mm-hmm. Okay, so there's also a dimension on the drawing. It's 30 foot 7 inches from north to south, and the only dimension I see on the interior of the room is 16 foot.
Right, there's 16 feet across to where the wall is.
But then...
Where the doorway is. Because the building doesn't take, the bottom of the basement doesn't take the whole plan of the, this is the plan that we got from you guys.
Well, but we didn't create the plans, we just were nice enough to go into our archives and dig out the original plans. But the drawing that you gave is 52 foot 2 inches at the bottom.
Right.
There's only 9 foot 2 off of that, which leaves approximately 40 foot, and you've got 16 foot.
Okay, I don't know why that would... We can figure out the difference. I mean, the walls haven't changed, Ben.
Well, I'm not saying that they have.
Yeah.
I'm just saying that the dimensions don't jive.
Yeah, I don't know where that was on there before. What were we measuring before? This is your handwriting. I don't remember. What were we measuring? Yeah.
I think that
one. 52.2.
Yeah. Okay, I don't know where that one came from. Let's see, this one's 10. This one's copy.
A part, yeah, part of the wall there. Okay, so let's make that 43, which is what it is.
Make it what?
43 inches, or 43 feet, which would mean the difference.
Well, it...
I don't know what the 16 is.
Mm-hmm. It really won't be 43 because that 52 is outside a block wall to outside a block wall.
Okay.
The 9'2" is inside a wall, and I'm assuming you've got a 12-inch block. So that
would assume so.
10 foot.
Yeah.
That's
9
foot.
I would assume
and
so.
That, and then your interior would also subtract another foot.
From off of that, correct.
It'd be roughly 39 foot.
That's fine, Ben. We're not moving walls, there's too much concrete above it.
All we're trying to do is clarify a drawing.
All right.
So.
We can cross off that 16 because we don't know where it is, right?
Yeah, cross out 16 because...
Well, your bottom dimension of 52, you got 52 on the top and the bottom.
Correct.
Anyway.
Oh, okay, so 52 at the top and the bottom, so the 50... The 52 is handwritten. So I doubt that one's correct because the north dimension is wider than the south dimension. So they both can't be 52.
Now the front of the building is 52.2.
Well, but it has at the rear of the building 52.
I see that.
So that's got to be incorrect.
It's got to be incorrect at the top.
Actually, that's the one that's the closest.
Just 16 here.
Yeah, just cross that one out.
That one.
Again, we've made no changes in the building.
What was the 16.4?
I'm trying to figure that out.
Or did you measure?
Yeah, I don't know, this was from something we had.
Oh, no. What if it's just a measurement of the stairway?
It could be from.
Excluding the, where the water suppression area and then the hallway as well.
Well, that doesn't make sense either, but you know, if you scaled it out, that's a lot bigger than 16 foot.
That's what I was looking at now.
Sixteen feet, yeah, then you got this, then you got nine.
It's possible to link the stairway.
So this furnace that you've drawn in here is not in a mechanical room and you have another furnace?
There is a furnace down there, that is correct. We've never even turned it on.
Okay, so again, so you have a furnace that isn't in a mechanical room. Do you have furnaces in a mechanical room?
No. Why would there be a furnace in the mechanical room? That's where my files are.
So there's nothing in the mechanical room?
I have my files in there. You have the elevator room and then I have files in there, all my files.
Well, the elevator room is not a room, that's an operating elevator, correct?
Right.
No, there's a room for the elevator because it has to have all the big base there. And the elevator, there is an actual room there for the elevator. Oh, actually, you know what? I
well,
see
maybe
what
that's
saying.
The mechanic. That's
it's part,
the mechanical.
There is part of that is part of the mechanical room,
yeah,
then.
You're right.
Okay, so we
you
can't
are
have
correct.
Both ways.
You are correct, Ben.
Okay, all right, okay. All right, okay. So the furnace. Was this furnace always there?
Always there.
Okay, all right.
I don't think we've ever even turned it on. Because it stays warm enough down there.
Oh, it's just for the basement?
Yeah, it's just for the basement.
Trash issue, and I don't see anything in here.
Why are we addressing the trash issue? That did not make any sense to me.
You're expanding the usage of the building.
Ben, I'm not serving any meals. We're going to have a seminar.
Well, that's okay. We're not saying what you're going to do with
busy
your seminar,
is our
but
trash.
It's increased usage. To our knowledge, you don't have any type of a dumpster, so.
Well, you wouldn't let me have a dumpster.
Well, there's no place to put it, so.
I understand. So our question again, my question stands as to what do you do with your
busy
trash?
Busy is our trash people.
Okay, so I'm who is your trash people?
Busy Bee. Busy Bee Disposal and Recycling.
Okay.
From Romeo.
And how do you dispose of your trash?
We have that little room on the side.
Okay.
Is that where the apartments also put their trash?
Yeah. Right now, there really isn't hardly any trash because we just have the apartments. My office doesn't really create trash. I create a whole lot of paper in those files, but not much trash.
And
I serve my clients coffee and water, so that's trash, but it really isn't trash.
You mean addressing it just as literally as her saying that she's going to share the trash amongst all the uses that are there? That's the old property owner, right?
Yeah.
That's
well, the big thing is there is no place for it.
And
how many apartments do you have rented at present?
Three. We have one that's empty, but there's a deposit on it.
I'm sorry.
The apartments have pretty consistently been rented. We've had few gaps in between when the mortgage, or when the leases have expired. I talked to you about having a trash can out on the street. Remember we went round about that? And everyone else in town can do it but me. Which still doesn't make sense.
Well, nobody can have a trash can sitting on the sidewalk in a C1. So nobody does that.
Yeah, but Scroll Away does, the bar does, all of those have trash cans out there. I have the photographs to prove it.
On the streets? I've never seen
that. On the sidewalks, they put it right out there once a day for the trash, Mr. Shoemaker, and then...
Well, yeah, they put it out on trash day, but it doesn't sit there all...
Right. Oh, we wouldn't do that either.
And they're not C1, they're C2.
And we wouldn't leave it out there either all the time. We wanted to wheel it out on the street. Because we had it worked out to share a dumpster, and as the other businesses do in town, and we wouldn't approve that either. That was a problem.
No, that's not true. We said that you could share a dumpster. You just need to bring that in so that you could share a dumpster.
We had that on our first proposal. Larry and I were sharing a dumpster.
But the dumpster sharing has to be within 300 feet, and it has to be a permanent thing. So it can't be a temporary thing. So if it's temporary, so you should just have an agreement with Larry. Now Larry sells a building, he's no longer there, now you have a new resident. What do you do with your trash?
So if we had shared a dumpster, who would you suggest we would share a dumpster with?
I don't know, it has to
there
be somebody.
There is no space and no place.
Excuse me?
There is no space and no place.
Well, that's not the Planning Commission's dilemma, it's the building owner's dilemma.
Well, you approved it to be able to have that, so.
Actually not, we did not prove it this way. The building wasn't built to the approval. The building was built with a centralized trash system and a compactor. That's how the building was approved. It was not built that way, so. You were incorrect that we approved it this way. We did
so
not.
You want me to burn this trash?
No, a compactor. Mr. Sledge was chairman at that time.
Yeah, it was Marcello's.
Well, there was never a compactor put in that building.
Understood. But again, that's how it was approved. It was never approved the way the building sits. That seems to be the issue at present.
Okay, so what is your issue with Busy Bee picking up our trash?
With increased usage, every time you come in, we're going to look at the trash issue, because you have, at present, three apartments rented. You have one building space downstairs rented. You occupy. You don't have the second floor occupied. Two-thirds of the bottom floor, the first floor, are vacant. As each one of those are occupied, you're going to create more trash. At that more trash, you're going to eventually need to have some type of receptacle, and that needs to be addressed.
So how do you suggest we set up a receptacle if you want
to
have one?
I would say to get some type of a legal agreement with the neighbor.
What's in there now? What did get built?
I think they just, correct me if I'm wrong, but you just have a room, an empty room,
right,
with the double doors outside, correct?
Right.
So what if she puts a receptacle in there? And then the trash could, the original plan was a unit that would have been there that the side load would pick up and then dump for that site.
Correct.
But you're right, it was all part of a compacted system. What if she just has a receptacle in there?
If it's compacted and it's not compacted, is the volume going to be the same?
I hear you, but just what she's got now, what are you doing now?
We have a big dumpster on wheels.
It's in that
room. It goes into the dumpster,
so
on the wheels.
All right. So it's a matter of, any added is a gross, and you're right, I agree with you.
As it grows, there's more and more left,
and it's a big room. It's a big room in here.
How big is it?
I don't know. Probably hold three of those big dumpsters.
With the big dumpster.
The ones on wheels, the big roll out.
No, I don't remember those 93-gallon ones, I imagine.
Okay, so the plastic one.
With the wheels.
So it's a tote?
Yeah.
Okay, so it's not a big dumpster, it's just a tote?
Yeah.
So it's a personal residential tote?
Yeah, we can get three of those in there.
All right.
We don't even fill one.
Mine's overflowing after a week.
Yeah.
We can't carry that much more.
Yeah, I guess.
So at some point in time, you're going, if the building is rented, totally rented, that probably will not be sufficient.
Yes.
All right, we'll address that when we get there. Right now, we're still trying to get it rented. I gotta get this thing.
Well, understood, but we're not gonna approve this process until you know that, you know, each time you add something, we're gonna need to address that.
So we're adding a few cups this time.
All I'm trying to do is let you know that you need to do something for the future. So look towards that.
All right.
Other than just coming in and saying, well, hey, we addressed this last time. You need to look for the future on that one.
Okay, makes sense.
You're making a conditional approval, are you?
Yes.
I forget that's where you're going, but I wasn't sure.
Yeah.
I agree. Otherwise, it won't get done.
Correct. Correct. And that was the advice of the planner also.
Any other questions?
We'll leave the meeting. Thank you. Thanks for your input. Any further discussion?
All right, so how do you feel about these dimensional inaccuracies?
Discrepancies.
You want to get them cleaned up? Part of if we're going to put a condition, you want to put a condition to get them cleaned up?
I think we should. We need to have it on the file. Mm-hmm. And like you said, we're already going to put a condition, so we should have it where it's all together for future.
You want to just make notations on your drawings?
I'm just add, you know, it's discussion at that point.
Sure.
If this is the record though, and something comes back with, mm-hmm. The only concern is there is another change or something, and now we have dimensional issues because a lot of stuff is by square foot or whatnot. Mm-hmm. Now we don't have that, the actual stuff.
Yeah,
you know, we know they're not right.
No, we know.
I was gonna bring a ruler with me and start doing the scale.
Correct.
I wasn't at the first meeting. We get the fire department thing cleared up.
Yep.
There's fire suppression. Yep.
Fire department has okayed. The sprinklers are in. Signage is correct. Emergency lights are there.
Perfect.
No, I wrote this. That's mine. I did that. I just did the math.
I'm assuming that means
it's the sign 210.
Yeah.
So it came up with 49 or 42, and it really should be 44. Right. Yeah, because this is another black wall, and that would be another wall. Harry, Mr. Roddy?
He addressed everything.
Okay. So then we're going to request a new drawing.
What would the board like to do?
Well, I agree with Chris. If we're going to approve this, we should have everything just the way it is physically. I mean, you've got 52-2 up here, you've got 52-2 down here. You can see it's wider up in the north end than it is at the south end on the street end there. And if something comes up and we have an issue with any measurements.
It's not representative of the drawing.
I agree, and any other commission, I think, would ask for the same in any other municipality.
I know that as chairperson of the zoning board, that if the dimensions aren't right, then take them back and get them right, then we can deal with the issue. You can't just come in, well, it's about 452 feet, or it's about, no, I don't need it, it's about.
You need it set.
You need exact measurements and...
Okay, well, how about, would you entertain the passing it on contingents?
Yes.
Contingency, so that until the new drawing just comes in, so we don't have to go to another meeting?
Right, absolutely.
Make sure these things are...
And the trash issue, did you want to put that into the next thing?
Yes, your turn. Okay, so what we did last time and with the building inspector's recommendation, I'll kind of read you some stuff and then you guys interject when I'm done, okay? So one of the conditions of approval, and this would be contingency of a new drawing coming in, occupancy of 49 or less persons, that would be a total. That doesn't mean you would have 49 people coming to your meeting. That would be 49 people, including whoever is occupying that space.
We usually have about 25 when we're well under.
Well, that's good. But we're just putting that as a condition. And this is also only for business use, no school, church, or residential use, personal use. It is a commercial space, so in the C1 district is a very small district and needs to be kept as that. The drawing will need to be clarified and acceptable, so the drawing needs to be legible and be consistent. And any further additions, rentals, need to be addressed. The trash issue needs to be addressed. So at present, there's three apartments rented, one downstairs unit occupied, and we will consider the basement meeting room as occupied. And we'll note that there's three residential totes being used for trash receptacles at present. No, the drawing would be, your approval would be finalized until you got the drawing in.
Right. You just got to remeasure.
So you got four conditions.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Yes.
Okay. And there's only one you'd put a time frame to anyway, and that would be just the drawing production. And like Ben said, you're going to hold that continuum, so that's fine. The other one is you don't have a time frame for the next approval, right? And God forbid we put a date, because then if once the year goes by we get caught what we had with the first time with this is now you have to come back for a, although this is not a special approval, thank God.
Yeah.
And then you have to reapply.
So any further discussion, anything that anybody else wants to add?
No, sound good.
Okay. Motion to approve as presented.
So moved.
Becky, do you want to read it again? Anybody want it to be read?
I just put approved with the following conditions. The new drawing with the correct dimensions, occupancy of 49 or less, space to be used for business use only, no school, church, or residential use. Further building occupation would require additional trash accommodations. Currently, three trash totes being used.
Residential and or personal use.
No.
Oh, okay.
The only for business use part?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
It's your building.
I know, it's my building.
Is it Paul?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, anyone for a second? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? So moved.
All right, we'll get the drugs back to you next 48 hours.
Wonderful.
Any questions?
So once you bring that drawing in, we'll have a, excuse me, once you do the drawing, bring that in, finalize, so we can have the drawing go with the application. You'll, excuse me, you'll sign a, the document, I'll have signed the application, and you'll get a copy of the conditions and the application.
Okay.
Okay, very good. Good luck.
We're done.
We're done.
Okay. Moving along. Armada Healthcare Associate. Okay, in our minutes that we didn't approve, it said that there was going to be a meeting with the village rehab people, and that did take place last month, so Lauren, or excuse me, Amy Chesson, Amy Neary.
Neary.
Was present, yeah, sorry. And Andy Wicklund from the village and myself. And then the rehab center had many engineers, architects, and owners present. So that meeting went very well. It was very constructive. Did everybody get the copy from McKenna? And the copies from McKenna? So, okay. I also have something from Giffords Webster, but I think I'm the only one that has it other than,
You were just given to us tonight, so.
I understand that. I didn't realize that there was only one copy.
Yeah.
So, Jeff, you're here. You want to do just a little presentation of kind of what you're doing?
Sure. You know, we already have a skilled nursing facility and the assisted living on the premises. We're proposing to add approximately 15,000 square foot independent living attached to the assisted living, which will be 15 apartments with a kitchen, living area, sleeping area, and a bathroom. There'll be a large entrance area with a lounge and dining area with a little snack bar, bistro, whatever you want to call it right there, with a patio to the outside for residents to utilize. There'll be laundry facilities in the building. There'll be several rooms. One will be used possibly for activities, another one for possibly a movie theater, something like that, depending on how the residents, what kind of residents we get. It's going to be what we call independent with assist, where we'll have people in our assisted living. We'll be able to provide services if someone needs a bath, needs medication assistance, or maybe just wants their apartment cleaned more frequently than just we throw in with the regular fee. It's going to be positioned off the back of the building, which I always get confused. I think it's southwest, I'm not sure, of our building. And we have adequate land. We have approximately 27 acres there, and I think we still have about 10 that will be undeveloped. So, any questions or any? I think you've probably all seen the buildings.
Yeah. Oh, did I?
Yeah, you mean it sounds good. I was ready to sell my house and move.
Good. I got an application right here.
Hold on, Paul. I'm not too far behind you.
I'll come with you guys on Sunday. I like the movies. Well, how many apartments did you say again?
15.
And what is the, is there
approximate square footage of each apartment was about?
525. Yeah, we're gonna, we're gonna license it as an adult foster care, so it'll be 20 units, it'll be licensed as a 20 bed. So we may have 15 apartments, but let's say you wanna bring your wife if you're married, you could stay in the same apartment together, see? Or maybe you don't.
You got Paul thinking.
Do those beds need to be certified as, in the same way as your nursing home beds?
No.
Because they're independent?
They'll be certified as similar to our assisted living.
Okay.
That's it, yeah.
Are we gonna go over this thing?
Yeah, actually, did everybody kind of have a chance? You've had the drawings for a while that were initially submitted. These are kind of preliminary drawings, if I'm correct, the ones that were distributed at the first meeting. So these aren't the final drawings, but this gives you a really good outlay of what's going on. Before we get into the Giffords, Webster, and McKenna things, did you do anything with the driveway? We talked about the driveway to get it so that the approach was all in the village domain and not in the township. Did you reroute that driveway?
I think they just shortened the
approach
so that it stays on our property. It's not the driveway wasn't going to be moved or shifted, but the approach was going to be shortened.
Okay, well, we talked
more similar to what is there existing.
Mm-hmm. Okay,
in the current driveway.
Okay. This will also have to be a special approval land use. So after we're done tonight, or before we're done tonight, we'll have to schedule a special approval land use meeting for our meeting next month, which will be our main meeting on this. So this is kind of a preliminary, get adjusted, find out what's going on, and get most of the stuff ironed out before we go into the public hearing. So, anybody got anything to say? Did everybody have a chance to go with the McKenna stuff? Would you like to discuss it?
I just had a couple questions, I guess.
Well, there's two. One is
the standard site plan, and the one's the special approval.
I'm looking at
That's the standard approval. That's the special approval.
Yeah, I'm looking at the standard approval one. I was a little confused about the
parking.
The parking space is required to be 20 feet. The applicant has proposed 18-foot parking stall length. 2 feet must be added to the length of each parking space. An 18-foot space could be acceptable if it were where it is designed to overhang the sidewalk. However, it is not acceptable for it is designed to overhang landscape. And I'm not sure what that.
Well, that was handled at the meeting in last month, and really, didn't we come up with that you had enough maneuvering room that you could use the 20 foot? So the 18 foot no longer applies.
Okay. The next one was about the all parking lots must be constructed with asphalt or concrete pavement unless the applicant demonstrates. I won't read the whole thing. Didn't we at one time go towards the idea of an aggregate of some kind that was more drainable than blacktop or asphalt as the county recommended? Was that discussed?
Yes, but that's not for, it was at the Planning Commission discretion. So where you're gonna have traffic in the, patients coming in and out, and residents coming in and out, and staff coming in and out, that you would really want to have to be asphalt or concrete. It would be
more resilient and smooth level. Okay.
Yep. Yeah, and something where maybe the maintenance guys or overflow parking or something like that could go to a gravel type surface.
Okay.
These people, they're not going to be having cars because they're assisted living.
Well, they're independent, so yes, they could have cars.
Okay. Are you going to be, are you entertaining the idea of a bus system for them as well, or?
We're planning to buy a, like a 16-passenger bus that will have possibly two or three what are called lockdowns for wheelchairs. Mm-hmm. To use to take people on shopping trips to the movies, you know.
Doctor's visits.
Yeah, whatever. Well, we already have a small minivan that we can take people to doctor's visits.
Okay.
Where you have two lockdowns in that.
Okay.
We already have that. We just had it wrapped. You know, see it walk right. I'll drive it around town tomorrow. It looks beautiful. Got the old direction. Got all our signage on it. It looks great. Yeah.
Okay. The next question I had was on the sidewalks, and they recommended that they put sidewalks along the right of way in front. There is, doesn't that fall on the village to do that, or do they have to get with the village?
Because
the sidewalks don't go all the way out that far.
Correct. The facility, if the way Amy's got it written, is the facility would have to do the sidewalk in front of their building, and hopefully the village, when they do the street project or sooner, could connect the dots.
Oh, okay.
Is this, so the sidewalk something we have to do with this project, when we do this project? Because then you're going to come and rip the street up, aren't you, to do the sewers out that way?
I don't know exactly when they're going to do the sewers or what they're going to do with the sewers. So, but if they had to take the sidewalk out to replace the sidewalk. So Andy could answer that question more than I.
Well, I don't think at this time there's really any plan to do the sewers in the immediate future. So when they did do them, if they were in conflict with the sewer, then yes, they would take them out and then they would replace them. But there's no plans immediately to do that.
So that I guess I just, you know, there's never been a sidewalk out there, for us to, so you want us to put a sidewalk from leaving a block or a house where there doesn't have a sidewalk, and put our sidewalk there. Where would we have to run it?
That's not my comments. I'm not sure, but it's pretty common practice when developing a lot that they do make you put in a sidewalk for that block.
So just go to your property line. You wouldn't be responsible for anything else.
Like the place just east of you that doesn't have sidewalk, you wouldn't have to do anything with that. That's
correct.
No.
Their grandfather, I'm sure, as far as not putting a sidewalk in there. Village has never been to put a sidewalk in there.
So we'd have to run it all the way along the road? Is that what you'd propose? I mean, I'm asking. I don't know where you'd want it.
Well, I'm not sure either.
Yeah, so I was trying to look at the picture up there to see. I mean, what the heck did
we talked about it at that meeting, extending the sidewalk. I mean, that was discussed.
Oh, it was discussed, and I was under understanding it would be something that we were planning to do in the future to make it accessible to our residents to get downtown.
Did you get the McKenna review?
Yeah, I got it.
It's discussed in their item 5. Walkways are provided to facilitate pedestrian access as required. So, if Mr. Boyd said that, that would be part of it. What's happening in the 2016 expansion or redoing of West Main?
West Main, I know we would like to put in sidewalks, but that'll be when they get ready to do the construction, see where the budget's at, and they'll decide whether they have the money to do that or not.
What about the train, though?
Right, so I'm more interested in the underground.
The underground right now, that's going to pay for the road itself. We're still investigating the underground.
Okay, so that one's okay. But nobody really knows where that one's at present.
Yeah, there's no immediate plans for that.
But it's still under discussion.
Yeah, it's a good time to discuss before we do the road, for sure.
Okay. So that road project at present is just the road project? But this is a, what type of funding? What is it?
The water line out there is primarily new.
It's what?
New.
Yes, but the sewer line isn't, is it? And where do they extend to? Don't they only go to the fire hydrant?
Yeah, just before the edge of the property, of the village.
They what?
The last fire hydrant before the end of the village.
Correct. But they don't extend out to the end of the village?
I don't think so. No, because it stops at Palmer Ridge.
Yeah, I mean, it's, let's see what the scale is.
Okay. Okay, so let's just go through, this is the regular, since we started with this one, and this is the regular approval.
Are you on 03 or 04? I just want to hear the difference. Is this SLU number 13-004 and 03?
Yep, 03.
03, okay.
03, yeah, see the site plan with the acronym. And you've got your special.
Yeah.
Oh, I see.
Yeah. And it, okay, so, and these are just recommendations.
Mm-hmm.
So, since, I'm just going to read this since the, being televised and nobody else, the audience can't see what we're looking at. As proposed, the expansion of the village rehabilitation care community facility meets many of the requirements of the village zoning ordinance, and we are in general support of this project. The following items must be addressed to the satisfaction of the planning commission prior to approving the proposed development. One, special land use approval is granted. Two, the maximum number of parking spaces permitted is addressed. And I'd like to discuss that one afterwards. We're just going to run down this. Mm-hmm. Parking lot surface is addressed. Parking lot spaces are dimensional. We already discussed that one, to the requirements. Walkways are provided to facilitate pedestrian access as required. Number six, a complete landscaping plan is submitted, which addresses the removal of trees and provides required landscaping and details. Seven, any utility and mechanical equipment is screened. Eight, street yard landscaping is addressed. Nine, detailed and labeled facade elevations to be proposed. The facility are provided. 10, photometric plan with all proposed and existing light fixture design details is submitted. And 11, detailed elevations of the trash enclosure are submitted. So some of this stuff, we have being familiar with the site, you have a really good, I'm just going to work backwards, you have a really good trash enclosure, so I don't know if you're going to expand, if you need to expand that. If you do, I'm sure it's going to be match what you've got. The lighting thing, I'm sure will be in your finalized plan. Same with the elevations. What Amy was going off of was the preliminary plans that were submitted in September, isn't that correct?
Mm-hmm.
So a lot of this stuff is just off of the preliminary plan, which will are going to be addressed in the future plans. Utility and mechanical, again, future plans. Landscaping plans submitted, future plans. Walkways are provided. We've discussed that. The parking lot spaces are dimensional. According to requirements that we've already addressed. Parking lot surface, once we see the final plans, we'll discuss that. Maximum number of parking spaces permitted. Okay, so this one, if you look at, where does she?
Second page.
Is it the second page?
Point number three.
Yeah, okay. If I'm not mistaken, so there's 44 places with two barrier-free spaces in the proposal. So, but part of your increased parking was to get additional parking for your existing development already, correct?
Well, what happened is when we built the assisted living nursing home, we expanded the nursing home, we put in more spaces than we thought were needed. But we have a lot more visitors, which is great. You want to have visitors in. But we have a lot more families coming in, so they're utilizing a lot more spaces than we anticipated. So we're hoping that by expanding the parking lot where, in this aspect, we can move some people out there, some employees out there to expand some of our parking that way.
So that wouldn't account for the whole 44, but kind of as just stated, there's a minimum of 11 parking places and a maximum of 18. But if you have 15 rooms and say half of them have cars, then you've got 7 or 8 cars that are there all the time. Plus you have employees. I think it's the requirement is on a minimum 1 or 2 dwelling units per 5 beds plus 1 on-duty employee based on the maximum employees per shift. So the 11 is really quite, it is only adequate if you don't figure in visitors. Mm-hmm. And even if you figure in visitors and you have 15 rooms, I know my mom was in the Alzheimer's wing, my sisters and I, all visitors, so that was 3 cars for 1 room, and she shared a room with somebody. So I think that, and we can easily be mobile towards an increase in parking places as we should in this instance. So. Okay, so I wanted to address that one. Any discussion on the consideration?
Okay. Sorry, you're right, it doesn't take into account the visitors. So.
I don't think it does. I think maybe the ordinance needs to be addressed.
It's a good point, yeah. Because it doesn't take care of it at all.
No.
Even if it's any one of those side amendments, not necessarily amended, but is included the supplemental thing. Mm-hmm.
Well, and it does say that we can adjust that as we deem necessary. That, as earlier stated, if you have an event, so you have a movie night, so all your residents, you have maybe some, and I know some of your employees, and some of your employees may actually come on their time off to spend with the residents. I just know that. And then now you have, more, you have grandkids plus the kids mm-hmm. coming, so you could easily well go over your maximum in your parking places. So
one of the things we want to do too is we want to involve the community more, and this is more of an independent living, so it'd be more like an apartment. So try to get work with the senior center in town to try to get more projects and vets going between the two facilities so that we have more people from the community coming out spending time there.
Okay, so then the last one was special land use, which we already talked about. So any more discussion on site plan review 13-003?
All right, just to make sure. So what you feel the issue with the parking space sizes and the surface has already been addressed?
The surfaces, no. Surface will be addressed as we get the new plan.
But there's an understanding of the parking size and an understanding of what material would be suitable.
Yes, well, that's addressed, but the parking size is addressed already in the 18-foot versus the 20-foot. And then this would be the number of spacing, which we just addressed. And then as far as the parking surface, that is yet to be construed.
They don't have any wetland delineation and all that, do they, with any tree removal or anything? Remember how with the how wet it had?
Mm-hmm.
It is by the basin areas.
Pat, you've got the landscaping. Mr. Conroy, you have the landscaping plan. That's, there isn't any wetlands in that area.
Not that we're aware of, no.
Okay. In the FEMA map, there's nothing shown back then. Okay, so now we're addressing special land use 13-004. This is all pretty much standard. If you've kind of read that, it really just states that it needs to be done, and you know what we're doing is prudent.
Yep.
And other than that, proceed.
I only have one question, and
sure.
I'll try to keep it short. Somewhere in there, they mentioned here about a possible barbershop, salon, or whatever being put in there. Didn't I read that someplace in the...
No, we currently, we're going to utilize the barber or the beauty shop that we have in our assisted living.
Okay.
We're not going to add another beauty shop.
Oh, okay, okay. That answers my question. Thank you.
And that might have been mentioned. So.
I think you're somewhere that Amy's thing had said that they could have some commercial if they wanted.
Right. But not some storage.
Yeah, but, yeah.
And it's all assisted.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Answer my question. Thank you.
It was there, but yeah, it's assisted.
Okay. So then, if I may, guys want to look at these maps. These are ones put forth by Mr. Whitman. This is, that's the existing, Andy? Is that correct?
No,
this was the new one. Yeah, this is existing and proposed. Okay, so this kind of matches what we've got. The only thing that, and then here, one of them, and yeah, okay, I've got three of them.
So there's the approach issue you're talking about.
So this is what I was talking about, the approach that would be outside the village. So they're just going to shorten that so that we don't have to deal with the township. And speaking of the township, I did notify the township planning commission chair that this project was under consideration. DJ, yeah. DJ Garrett. He's putting in a hot water heater this evening.
That's always fun.
That sounds like,
he said he didn't want to take any more cold showers.
Getting cold from it.
Excuse me?
Getting cold from it.
Now that we've configured the approach to make it to cover.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Okay, I was doing really good. Okay.
Final drawings. Yeah.
When do you think you'll have your final drawing?
Well, as I understand, you've got to account for the 28th of November that will be the final. And our idea is to get the final plans into you at least a month ahead of time.
Which, well, actually, a month ahead of time is today.
That's not as I understand.
2 weeks.
Well, yes, that's about when we have to submit them. And then you have them for a couple of weeks, then you have another console. So it's actually almost like 2 months?
No,
November.
We're going to have, yeah. Our meetings are the first Monday of every month. So.
And there's only one?
We only need one more month unless you need more time.
Well, Paul had talked to you about having it like the 28th of November.
November 4th is the next meeting opportunity, right? Yeah, so I think we're anticipating having drawings submitted on the 18th.
18th of this month?
Yes.
Okay, correct. All right, okay, good. That's what I was trying to.
Okay.
Okay, so then that way, because if we get all the drawings and everything's all set, it's possible, you know, that we can move forward at that meeting. If not, then we have to continue to have more meetings. So.
Well, that's our plan, to have a few by the 18th.
Okay, good, good. Okay. So the letter by Giffords Webster about their review. I'm not quite sure. Andy, you've got approved as noted and approved as noted on the drawing. But I didn't see any notations on the drawing. So the notations are really in here.
Yeah, most of them are in there, other than there's a few that we call out on the plans. A couple of them are presentation items.
Oh.
So it's very hard to put those on there.
All right, okay, that's confusing. So, and then, do you guys have a copy of Giffords Webster?
Yes.
Okay. So and then you're totally understanding of what's going on here?
Yes, his letter was self-explanatory and
good.
And they're pretty standard, and we'll make sure we have that detail. We'll have probably even more detail than that on our site plan.
Good, okay. So then, so are there any questions by any of you guys as what's needed?
No, regarding the engineering review, not at all.
Okay. From the board? I happened to talk to Mr. Conroy earlier today. It was about the trees.
Yeah, who inventoried all those trees?
I was.
That must have been a.
So, lost a fortune.
I was going to say that.
Yeah, I wouldn't want to tape it up for that.
I think so.
When it did back in there, it was just well, what would your guy have to go through to do all those trees? What would you call that stuff you had to walk through?
Okay, so one of these is
thistle. It's one of the worst areas they ever walked through, our woodlands.
How many of those trees are you going to take out?
None. Good ones?
No, I just
most of the trees in there are like pear trees, and they're not a lot of them are really good trees, but we obviously have to take the trees out where the building and the parking lot's going. But south of that, we've looked at areas where we're bringing our sewer through, and we've indicated only trees that are not really worth that much that we're going to be taking out at a minimum. So
I was just thinking about as a wood carver maybe coming in when they're taking them out and scavenging a few sticks for like walking sticks and stuff like that. I'm just always thinking ahead.
Come by me, you can go by anytime.
Yeah,
there'll be a few cords of wood.
We can flag what you can take out.
If you start now going in there, we won't have to do so much.
Well, I saw the count. Yeah.
We want to leave as many trees as possible.
Well, I understand that.
We want to have enough of an area buffer behind us, so we're not going to take out trees unless we absolutely have to.
Well, that's like I say. I'm just I'm always looking for myself and for other club members for saplings and stuff like that, or smaller sticks that are good for like canes and walking mm-hmm. sticks and things like that.
Should be a good area for it.
If you can get through it.
We're heavy clothes.
I got those. Now, I carry a small folding sawmill with my pickup, and I see something that saw that cut me off, goes and back to pick up.
Okay, if we can kind of get back to our meeting.
Sorry.
That's okay. Sidebars are good. But the issue of the trees, according to Ms. Neary's 13-003, the standard site plan review, on page 3, there's a landscaping section, and in the second paragraph, it says that proposed facility requires removal of 100 trees, including 54 good trees, 7 fair trees on the site. And then it says that the next paragraph is the site plan currently proposes 37 trees, 5 evergreens, and 4 ornamental for a total of 46 trees. And there is an indication, it should be noted that the majority of these trees are required for parking lot landscaping and not as replacement site trees. But if you look at, the reason I brought that forward, and Mr. Conroy did too, as indicated just a few moments ago, a lot of these are pear trees, which is, I do believe that section of town at one time was an orchard, even on the other side of Main Street was an orchard. So, and there's some cherry trees. Well, cherry trees get to be pretty good and a pretty good sized tree, but a pear tree really isn't. So I don't know what you guys would consider, but I'd like to look at the trees as far as what our planner has said, and then maybe consider knocking down that 54 good trees and, from deleting some of those fruit trees from the good, because a lot of there's just in the first paragraph or the first line, there's 1, 2. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. There's quite a few pear trees that are listed as good trees. But I think that we should consider having the requirement of trees along Main Street. Which now does not exist. Is that on the drawing? Are you going to put trees on Main Street?
You tell me on the part where there's already the existing structure existing.
Yeah.
That's the conditional approval.
I would say, where about one of these?
Sure.
Where do you want to put
them? Along Main Street.
You know, because you got the right of way, then you're going to have the sidewalk.
Yeah.
Yep.
And where naturally trees would be.
We've got a couple of right of way. There's 3 or 4 huge trees out there.
Are there? Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, that could be.
In front.
But and the requirement's only 1 tree per 40 foot. So we're not talking about, a lot of trees.
That's almost
a whole area shaded.
Excuse me?
You could talk about a lot of trees if you wanted to.
Well, yeah.
Yeah, you could, but the other thing too is keep, getting far enough away from the road, or the sidewalk, so you don't start tearing down.
Sure, too. Exactly. So anyway, so that's something to look at.
We'll do that.
Yeah.
You know, that tree listing, when it says good tree, that means the condition of the tree. That doesn't mean it's a good tree. It means it's a condition of the tree.
Yeah. Okay.
It's shape. It's shape and health.
And the health of it. Correct.
It doesn't mean the fruit offering is good. I mean, it was
not a okay, so then I was incorrect on how I carved those trees up. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Well, I stand corrected then. This will be the first time.
But on that
list. That's good in terms of monetary value.
Oh, okay.
But though, then they do have elm trees, or there's elm trees that are on there. Which, again, that's like a size. That's just a native size. Siberian elm, you wouldn't plant that today. There's buckthorn, which is an invasive species, which you don't want. You know, there's chokecherries. There's a slew of pears. There's also some probably old apples or crab apples out there that, again, have a reasonable shape, but at some point they have a lifespan that's going to, So out of that, there's only like 15 oaks and 5 maples. Out of the 67 that we have listed with the new plans, that's good. So,
well, I'm surprised you still have live elms and you have
no Dutch.
Well, they're not Dutch. Elm.
Ash borer.
Okay.
Dutch elm. But a lot of those do die out though. They're not a long lived tree. So, and the foresters going out there and they're making a judgment based on is it a 360 degree tree? Does it look pretty good? Is it pretty healthy?
that's what they're going. They're not commenting on species.
Okay, so that's just something to look at too. So, any more discussion from the board? It's nice to have a good set of plans and a good proposal.
This was wonderful.
Yes, yeah. And it's nice not to have to fight for the pensions.
We're not using the engineer to do the retention, detention, stormwater and all that for the applicant? Or they're doing it themselves and then have Andrew do it?
I'm not sure. Did you come to the conclusion whether or not the retention or detention needed to be increased?
It does.
It does?
It does.
Okay.
That's,
So we'll get the final drawings.
I plan to do that to increase it,
So it was kind of, at the previous meeting, it was authorized that the engineers and the professional people from the village could talk directly. So then when they come to the Planning Commission, that all that stuff would have been ironed out. So we just get a recommendation, a clear recommendation, and hopefully everything's cleared and thought through before it really comes to us. So this was kind of a get acquainted thing. So if everybody's ready about a motion to set a special approval land use public hearing for the next meeting.
I'll make a motion to hold a special public land use meeting.
Public hearing, and this is, hello, we are normally doing this, our Maida Healthcare and Associates. Okay.
What day?
And then the
November 4th.
Yeah, November 4th, and we should have that probably at 7:45.
Yeah.
Okay. Second to Lisa's motion or with discussion?
What's the advance notice? How much time do we have to have it published before we?
15 days, isn't it?
15. Okay.
So we have plenty.
We got plenty of time.
Right. Yeah.
Second.
And then if everything is here, kind of by the 18th, Andy. You'll have enough time after that, aren't you? I mean, you guys are pretty close right now, aren't you?
Yeah, that should be a problem.
I think the planner is too, so.
So the meeting starts at 7:45 for us to be here?
Yeah,
okay.
Correct. That will be the public hearing. The meeting will start at 7:30, but as you know, we have to do a few preliminary things prior, so. And then after we do the, okay, I'm sorry. So a motion, discussion?
None. Maybe I seconded.
Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? So moved. Okay, so public hearing is 7:45, November 4th.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Yes.
It's a very exciting project.
Yeah, we're excited. You know, it's fun. It's enjoyable working, being here in the community, and you know, it's been enjoyable working with you guys. I mean, it's been a pleasure. I hear all horror stories of other people in other communities.
Where'd you hear those from?
Yeah, I don't know. So it is, and we you know, enjoy being here. I mean, the community's been great to us, and I think we've been good for the community. So we tried to build a nice looking building, you know, attractive and be a good part of the community. So
that was one thing that wasn't really discussed was the exterior of the building. If you take a look at what's there now, it's pretty much the design of what's going to be built in the addition.
Okay.
The siding's color, the shingles are the color, a lot of so, landscaping around the building.
So you're just going to kind of keep the same theme that you had?
Absolutely.
Yeah, and that was in the planner's recommendation, either to upscale or to use if it matched existing, so.
Mm-hmm. Well, thank you, everybody.
Thank you.
Thanks. Motion to adjourn?
We still got
that. Yeah.
We can go.
Okay.
Thank you, John.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you.
forward to working with you yet. Good luck with the project.
Thank you.
Okay, so chair report. I have some bad news. Mr. Seals has resigned. So his resignation was effective immediately. That was a couple of days ago. So I really hope Tom would at least have stayed for this project, but because he's done a lot of this stuff from the other end. He's been, done it from that end. Mm-hmm. So anyway, we're sorry to see Tom. I'm sorry to see Tom go, and I hope everybody else is too. But so we need to find somebody else to fill his seat. Other than that, I have nothing to add to the chair report. And there's any public comments, Andy?
Wonderful meeting.
Okay. Motion to adjourn, if there's nothing else.
So moved.
Second?
Yeah, I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. We're out of here.
You too in here.